In this video, I am going to explain muscles that do internal rotation of hip. Internal rotation. Actually, there aren't many muscles which do internal rotations. I explain four muscles today. Okay, four muscles. First muscle is this muscle. This muscle is very popular in my videos. This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius, particularly on anterior fiber. Anterior fiber. If you divide gluteus medius to two parts, there is anterior part and posterior part. Anterior part does internal rotation because think about its direction. It goes this way, right? That is why this vector makes internal rotation. On the other hand, posterior fiber does external rotation because that pulls bone to this way. This vector makes external rotation. Does it make sense? And there is one muscle deep to gluteus medius, which is this muscle, this pink color muscle. This is gluteus minimus. Same like gluteus medius, you can divide gluteus minimus to two parts, anterior fiber and posterior fiber. Of course, anterior fiber does internal rotation. So is gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, posterior fiber does external rotation. These two muscles have so many functions, very important for hip and pelvic movement and stability. For next part, I'm going to explain rest of muscles. Okay, second part. Third one is this muscle. This is tensor fascia lata. Tensor fascia lata. It's on anterior part of pelvis and hip, slightly on lateral part. So is like gluteus medius. This muscle can also do internal rotation because of direction of muscle fiber. Does it make sense? Okay, tensor fascia lata, hip internal rotator. Very simple. The last one is kind of tricky and unique, which is this muscle. This is adductor magnus. Adductor magnus. It's very surprising. Main function of this muscle is, of course, adduction. And this muscle can do rotational movement. That's external rotation, actually. External rotation depends on location of fiber. This muscle can do internal rotation. Very unique muscle, right? Main rotational movement is external rotation, but depends on where the fiber is. This can do internal rotation. Unfortunately, I couldn't find the research which explains evidence of internal rotation. But if you look carefully, if you look up detail about adductor magnus, maybe you can find researches that says, okay, this part of adductor magnus does internal rotation. However, unfortunately, I couldn't find it. Anyway, adductor magnus may be able to do external rotation and internal rotation. Let's put question mark for this video. main rotational movement is external rotation, maybe internal rotation. In this video, I explained four muscles that do hip internal rotation. Gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, tensor fasciae latae, and possibly adductor magnus. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.